In every plant, Ellen Zimmermann finds a treasure in its visual beauty or fragrance. She also sees its potential, like a twiggy plumeria in spring that promises great things by summer. But along with the plant's appeal to the eyes and nose, she values its potential as a culinary and medicinal contributor. Her garden is both a backyard pharmacy and a spiritual retreat. To connect others to the healing powers of plants, Ellen started the Austin School of Herbal Studies.
I've been a psychotherapist for over 30 years and also a very avid gardener. And I was looking for something else to do career-wise, so I found a master herbalist named Rosemary Gladstar in Vermont, and I started studying herbs, and I have been consumed ever since, you know, because it gives me the opportunity to be in the garden, to grow my herbs, and help to pass on this very valuable and important information to people, because I do love educating and teaching people about health and how they can take care of their own health care in a very good and natural way.
These days, her plants are enclosed against the creatures that value them too. When Ellen and husband Tom traded their suburban dimensions for expansive land, they wanted tramps through the woods and to meet the wildlife that owned them. But to have a garden, Tom built an enclosure with the junipers he thinned. He created trails with them to define their personal space near the house. On a spacious patio, Ellen conducts some of her classes. For Ellen and Tom, it extends their split-level outdoor living room. Ellen added a disappearing fountain for its lullaby.
You need a water feature in the garden. It's just so relaxing and so calming, and I just love it.
Shade defers to sun in the cleared spot for Ellen's garden. It's always a bustle of activity. There's rarely a gap when someone's not showing off. She adds the touches that complete its unique expression. There's even a garden bed. A favorite spot for young granddaughters is the secret garden she and Tom built for the family's newest plant explorers. The main garden leads to another secret room, an arbor rebo as they call it, a rose arbor gazebo that Tom built. It leads to an alcove that ends at the deer fence to the woods. From the arborebo, Ellen can view it all in one sitting. Since it's essential that no harmful products come between you and the plants destined for recipes or medicinal preparations, Ellen hit on an organic solution when grasshoppers exploded one year.
And they would literally zoom right after the grasshoppers, and they would, you know, fight each other to eat the grasshopper. And within 1 week's time in my garden, I did not have a grasshopper problem.
Ellen's organic control for some weeds is to eat them, like the chickweed she cultivates on her patio.
Chickweed is a wonderful herb to deal with safely and effectively for urinary tract infections, as well as it's an herb you can eat every day if you did find it in the wild, because it has a lot of nutrients too. So it also deals with the kidneys. It helps support the kidneys. It helps with an itching feeling. So I use it externally. I put it in my itch relief salve. A weed is just a plant we don't know the use of yet. Or a weed is a plant that we do not want in our gardens. I really believe in my heart that every plant has been put on this earth for a purpose, and that purpose is to help heal our bodies. So I think if we look at what grows just in our own environment, and if there are some plants that some people do call weeds that do pop up in the garden, you might hesitate to pull them out because they very well have a use. We just don't know that use yet.
Ellen knows the healing value of the plants in her garden.
If you've had a rough day, a day full of nervous tension, in the evening you might go out into your garden and hopefully you have lemon balm, for example, in the garden, Melissa officinalis, and you can pick, harvest some fresh lemon balm leaves and brew up a tea, and that might very well help you deal with a little bit of anxiety and also relax you enough to fall asleep at night.
Many of her plants, even the chickweed, end up in her apothecary to be used for teas, tinctures, and salves. But a garden's therapy extends far beyond that.
The garden is my sanctuary. It's my backyard sanctuary. And in addition to learning about the plants medicinally, I've also learned from the plants and have now begun to pass on to my students about the deeper lessons from the plants, lessons like patience, being patient as a gardener, lessons of impermanence as things do not stay the same, lessons of community and sharing that the plants can teach you about so vividly. So I've really learned a great deal from the plants for life.